Hello and welcome to the Licardo Dovella White Shirts Kitchen. In this video we'll be showing you how to make two chia pudding recipes. Then we'll show you how to use them in five different ways. Example for breakfast or dessert or a movie night.
Okay, what do we need?
You will need milk,
chia,
dates.
To get started, grab your mixer and get 530 ml of milk. Any milk will do. We are using
oat milk.
Then grab 130 grams of chia.
No, we're not blending the chia.
What? How much of that stuff?
Dates. 60 grams of dates.
Cooking is never boring with you guys.
No.
Why are we putting the dates in?
To give it a sugary taste, do not start it.
Why can't we just use sugar?
We want to do it the healthy way.
Okay.
So we are putting dates. You can use anything. I will link it below.
Romeo, do not press it.
If you press it, I will.
I can't put that on.
Stop. You did it and it...
It went on me.
Okay, go.
Okay, let's shut it first. And now. After you've mixed it, open the lid and pour it into a bowl.
Next, add 135 grams of chia.
Then mix well.
Now that it's ready, put it in the fridge and come back tomorrow. Thank you for watching the video. This is the end. We'll put another video tomorrow on how to make it chia.
No.
We have one ready. This was in the fridge overnight. Now onto the next chia recipe.
Set it aside. What's the second one?
Next is sultana chia.
These are the ingredients you will need.
We just used dates to make that chia pudding sugary, but this time we're going to show you can use sultanas to make it sugary. We're going to make a smaller batch this time. First you have to add 350 milliliters of milk.
Then 60 grams of sultanas.
Yeah. Shut the lid.
Well. Yes.
And blend.
So that this doesn't happen.
And blend into a liquid.
The lid is on.
Yeah, I thought you were saying that it's breaking.
No. It's a horrible sound. Your butt turned the oven on. Every video, the butts turn the oven on. Don't. Okay, go.
Now that it's ready, pour it into a bowl.
And add 90 grams of chia seeds.
After you've poured it in, mix well. Now that it's ready, we're going to put it in the fridge and grab the one we made yesterday.
So this is sultanas.
We have five yummy chia ideas. We're filling two of them with sultana chia pudding and three of them with date chia pudding. For this first chia pudding dessert idea, it would be handy to have a jar with a lid so you can store it in the fridge or bring it to work. We have figs, pistachio nuts, and oat flakes.
Yes.
At first, we want to put something yummy in the bottom of the jar, so grab your figs and blend the rest and leave to a side for decoration. Blend your figs. They don't have to be totally crushed, just a little bit. That should be enough. Put the figs at the bottom of the jar.
And press it down.
I don't know where that came from.
No, okay, don't eat it.
It's really nice to dig under the chia to get the figs. Next, add some chia.
We are going to use date chia.
Then add some oats.
Then cut up your figs and crush your pistachios.
Yeah, I'm filming you.
Then throw them inside.
Then crush your pistachios.
Okay. Then put them on top. And then add the lid.
Store it in the fridge, eat it straight away, or take it to work. Or eat it the next morning. For the next one, you'll need strawberries and almond flakes. Crush all the strawberries except two for decoration.
Roast Tuesday. Now we crush these. Now that the strawberries are crushed, at the bottom of the chia, this will be the surprise. Put the strawberries into the jar. that. Now we add chia.
We are going to be using date for this one.
This is Nefertiti's favourite one.
Yeah, this is her favourite. I think with strawberries she automatically owns. Everything gets even.
Now add some oats.
For me, you're not letting the camera see anything. You could have kept that hand.
Whatever. Now add the strawberries.
And almond flakes.
Now the lid.
Two down. Third one to go.
Yes. In this one there's blueberry, agave and coconut. The blueberry will be the surprise at the bottom of the chia.
Grab your jar and put most of the blueberries at the bottom.
We don't crush our blueberries in this. Then add your chia on top of the blueberry. We are putting the date chia in this one.
We've got used to using these gherkin jars and there's a perfect little line that we always put the chia seeds up to. Is it up to the line?
Yes. Next we put some oats.
This is why we have oats on our floor in the morning or at night.
The rest of the blueberries.
You can see all our cooking videos on our board.
This is curry. This.
They haven't seen our curry video yet.
Next, put the coconut.
Mix it.
He put it on. Romeo, you had one job.
Stop being me.
No.
What's next?
Next is agave.
We're getting one tablespoon.
You don't need to add the agave if you don't want to add any sugars.
We just wanted to.
This is the only one we're adding sugar to.
Shut the lid, eat it tomorrow, today, tomorrow.
Next we have the banana and walnuts.
With the rest of the chia, when the camera turns off, we're going to make more jars.
Because five is not enough.
No.
Nope. And now we have the other chia.
Sultana chia.
Sultana chia.
So we have raw banana, walnuts, and dried bananas. Crush a banana. We know it's a bit overripe, but it'll still taste yummy. The surprise at the bottom of this will be banana. The banana will be the surprise on the bottom of the jar. Now pour the banana into the jar.
We recommend you to use a whole banana, but we can't go to the shops now, so we used half.
Because half the planet is shut.
Yeah. Next we have our sultana chia.
It looks really nice. I really like the sultana with the banana.
Yeah, it's a good combination.
It is. Try this one. Definitely try this one. And when you have that banana that's left over, look at the other video. You can use your banana to make chia. The video is linked below. So you can make chia banana plus put banana under the chia. So that's a great way to use up when you have maybe 10 bananas left over. When people have bananas left over, they think, oh, let's make a banana cake. But you actually don't need much banana for a cake. So this is the way to use it. Leftover banana. You can put up to 10 of them in chia. Put 10 bananas. Put some almond milk. Now what?
Now pour some oats on top. Then place some dried bananas.
We like putting dried bananas on the top. It's just something different. Have everything so pretty.
Crush 3 walnuts and put 1 walnut on the top.
I think they're crushed.
I may have cut my hand. No, I didn't.
Then put the lid on.
Last one, and it's not late at all.
It's not 7:00.
It's not late at night.
No, oh, you can see it.
Yeah.
In this one, there is dark chocolate coffee beans and raspberries.
First, get your jar.
And pour some raspberries on the bottom.
And that will be the surprise under the chia.
We've got frozen raspberries because in Finland, it's snowing outside. There's not any raspberries anywhere. But when summer comes, we can walk and find them.
Next, we add some chia.
Sultana chia. We just wanted to show that you can have different tastes. That doesn't have to always be the same.
Then add your oats. Then add your raspberries.
Then crush your coffee beans, leave two for the top. I think they're crushed.
And then get your two whole coffee beans and put them on the top. And put your lid on top.
Eat it tomorrow or today.
Here are our chia. I love education button.
Lotification. And. And. It's just taking time.
And
yeah, same.
And just so you know, the light
is hidden under my finger.
So it didn't help at all.
Oh, thanks.
Look at the mirror. Look at the mirror.
ET phone home. Oh no, seriously.
Thank you for watching our chia pudding recipe in 5 different ways. Remember when you make these recipes to tag us in your Instagram photos so we can share it in our stories.
And make sure to subscribe and like and leave a comment if you can and turn on the notification button.
Ha 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 ha.
Yeah.
Thank you for watching our chia pudding recipes. In this video we showed you how to make it in 5 different ways. Now remember when you make this. Remember when you make this recipe to tag us in your Instagram photos so we can share it in our stories. And
sure
subscribe,
like
and leave a comment if possible. And press the notification button.
Okay, it's time to really do it now. Get ready. Turn all the jars this way.
What?
Jars? Or this way?
Maybe a bit more this way. Too far. There's good.
I thought too far means it gets too far from me.
Shut up, just shut up. Just shut up. Okay.
Okay, stop. Press it on.
Stop, just stop.
Okay, go.
She's gonna wait. Wait, okay.
All you have to do is end the video.
Stupid.
You go like this. You go like this. And then I laugh. Okay.
We've done 2 videos today. These guys are really tired.
I can't.
It's your fault now.
Oh.
Okay now.
It's a good ab workout.
Come on, you just gotta end it.
I don't know what we're laughing at.
I don't know either.
Oh, it's 8 o'clock at night. We started filming at 10 in the morning. This is our second video.
I'm gonna be crying.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, stop.
Okay, go, 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 go. You just gotta end the video.
I'm crying.
Okay.
Okay.
Go and let him stand in front of you because you look too big. Okay. Thank you for watching our video.
Who the hell is what?
Okay, now I stop laughing. That's your fault.
Yeah,
no,
stupid.
Go.
Thank you for watching this chia pudding recipe in 5 ways. Remember when you make this recipe to tag us in your Instagram photo so we can share it on our story.
Make sure to subscribe and like and leave a comment if you can and turn on the notification button.
Thank you for watching.
Bye.
Bye. I noticed we both, instead of saying subscribe, he said shubscribe and I said, remember when you, I don't know, I used sh on all that.
I wonder if they can see because it's subscribe. So dark.
Subscribe. Say notification button.
Notification button.
It's hard when to say it.
Pistachio. It's hard when you're filming. Or peel your zucchini.
Peel the zucchini. We're all good?
Yes.
Yes.
Now to take We need to take thumbnails.
Yes.